today I am going to explain about the CMOS inverter. Okay, so CMOS inverter operation of this entire CMOS inverter operation we will be going to discuss now. Okay, so before entering into the CMOS inverter, before we will be having the various production. So actually in the CMOS inverter, it will be having a pull-up transistor and a pull-down transistor. Okay, so here in this, before entering into this, we will be having three different various pull-ups. So how we are going to vary it means by this pull-up transistor only. Okay, the pull-down transistor will be same. That will be the NMOS transistor only. Okay, the CMOS transistor will be the combination. That means it will be having the PMOS and the NMOS transistor. Okay, so the pull-up transistor will be PMOS transistor and the pull-down transistor will be the NMOS transistor. Right. So before entering into this CMOS inverter, as I have said that we'll be having the three different various pull-ups. So those are the what we are going to have means in this pull-up transistor only we'll be having the changes. Those are the first one will be the load resistor. And the second one will be the we are going to use this as depletion mode NMOS transistor. Depletion mode NMOS transistor. And the third one is enhancement mode NMOS transistor. Okay, so after seeing these three different various pull-ups, then we will be going for the CMOS inverters. Actually in these three different types of various pull-ups we will be having some disadvantages. Okay, so for the first one, just I am drawing rough diagram. See, I am just the first one will be the pull-down transistor. You know this is the NMOS transistor. Okay, so this is the pull-down transistor, and for this, and for the pull-up transistor will be the load resistor. I am writing it as here, the load resistor, and this is connected to the VDD, and this will be the VSS, and input where we are going to give will be applying here, V in, and the output will be getting from this. That means, see here also, this will be operating in the form of same inverter operation only. Inverter means what? I am applying the input as logic 0. Then the output will be getting as the logic 1. And then the next condition is what? I am applying the input as logic 1. And the output we are going to get it as the logic 0. Okay. So all these three, whatever these three different various pull-ups are there, here also we will be having the same inversion operation. And the output also we are going to get the same like the inverter. But coming to this, for all these three different types, we will be having some disadvantages, right? So for this first one, here I am going to apply the input. You know, I am applying input here and the output you are going to get it as the logic one. So here what it is going to happen for this arrangement means, here the pull-up transistor will be the load resistors, okay? So I am placing the number of resistors here. So that is the reason here it will be occupying the more area, okay? So a more area means again it will be coming as one of the parameter for this VLSI. Okay, so as you know that in this VLSI design it will be having the four different parameters: the power consumption, area, and then we will be testing that is the it should have some high speed and the testing time. Okay, so by designing any module, any one of these parameters should be satisfied for that. Okay, so in some cases we will be telling okay, so this will be it will be considering some less area, but at the same time it will be having some low, sorry, high power consumption. That means here high power consumption will be one of the disadvantage, and at the same time when it is occupying the less area means it will be having some advantage. That means there will be a trade-off between all these parameters. That means no any one of the module will be satisfying any one of this or any two of this particular parameters, but there will be a disadvantage in terms of area or the speed or the power consumption or the testing time. Okay, so when we are considering this first type, what is going to happen is in this arrangement the area consumption is there, right? So that will be more for this particular type, that is the load resistor. Okay, and then the second, in this second one, what is going to happen is again it will be using, that is the pull-up transistor, it will be having a depletion mode. That means I am drawing now, you know that what is a depletion mode. Okay, so this is one of the, this is the pull-up transistor which I am using, NMOS only, and the next one is pull-down transistor which I am using here. So this will be the pull-down transistor and this will be the pull-up transistor only. Okay, so as you are going to apply to this full on transistor only. Basically, we'll be calling it as a NMOS inverter. Okay, so this is the arrangement for this NMOS inverter. Okay, the pull up transistor will be in the depletion mode, and the pull down transistor will be in the enhancement mode. Okay, so for this consideration, what it is going to happen means it will be occupying, it will be requiring more power. This is one of the disadvantage for this. And then again, what it is going to happen means, see, for the first condition, I am applying input as logic 0, and the output, you know, you will be getting it as logic 1. Okay, so for this, and then I have to go for the second condition, that is what I am going to apply the input as logic 1, and the output we are going to get as 0, right? See, I will tell you with the help of a like this, the flow, I am giving the input as 0. For this, what is going to happen, what here I am placing the capacitor, because for the charging and the discharging purpose. Okay, so if I am applying input as 0, what it is going to happen, output will be getting it as 1, right? So that means the capacitor will be charging like this. Okay, so this is for the first condition. And second condition is what, I am applying input as 1, so the capacitor will be discharging. That means here for this, it will be taking more time to discharge, that means from high value to a low value. Okay, so it will be requiring some more power and at the same time more time. So this is one of the two disadvantages of this arrangement. That is the for the pull-up transistor, I am using a depletion mode, that is NMOS only. And next, for the pull-down transistor also, we will be using the enhancement mode, NMOS transistor. Okay, so this is nothing but simply a NMOS inverter. It will be doing the inverter operation, but it will be having these disadvantages. And next one is what, for this we will be using the pull-up transistor will be again enhancement only. Okay, so enhancement mode transistor I am using here. So for this also, it will be requiring again whatever this, it will be taking some extra time in order to transfer from this VGG value to the VDD. Okay, so these are all the different disadvantages of this three various pull-ups. Okay, so in order to satisfy all those, what we are going to do means we will be doing the some change in this pull-up only. See, for all these three cases we have done the change in pull-up transistors only. So here in this pull-up transistor, I am placing a PMOS transistor. Now we have to check how this, the combination of these two, that is this PMOS transistor and the NMOS transistor, we will be calling it as a CMOS inverter. Okay, so again the CMOS inverter will be doing the inversion operation, and we have to check, that means it will be taking some less power, and we are going to get the full swing, that is the at the output. Okay, so these are the main advantages of the CMOS inverter. So that is the reason, before entering into this inverter, first we have to know the what are the three different various pull-ups, that is the arrangements which we are going to get for this pull-up transistor, right? So now let's move to the CMOS inverter. Okay, so as I have said, it will be having a PMOS transistor and NMOS transistor. Okay, the PMOS transistor will be the, it will be for the pull-up transistor, and NMOS transistor will be for the pull-down transistor, right? So now I am drawing the PMOS transistor. Okay, so this is the PMOS I am giving, and then this is the pull-up transistor, and next I am using the NMOS transistor here. And you know that this is for the power supply VDD, and this we are going to consider as the ground. And you know, for each and every transistor, that is the CMOS transistor, complementary metal oxide semiconductor, for this the terminals will be what we are going to have, gate, drain and source. Similarly for the NMOS also, gate, drain and source. Okay, right? So now I have to apply the input. How we are going to apply the inputs? Just I am tying the gates of this both PMOS and NMOS transistor. You know, at the gate terminal only we will be applying the input. Okay, so I am taking here, I am applying the input, and next output from where we are going to take, we will be taking from these two transistors, terminals are there, right? So either it will be the drain or drain, or source or drain. Okay, so here I am taking the V out. Okay, so this is the arrangement of a CMOS inverter, right? So now we have to apply the input combinations, and then we have to check whether we are getting the output properly or not with the help of an equivalent circuit, right? So now first I am applying the input as logic 0. Okay, so by applying the input as logic 0, it will be passing like this, like this. Okay. So here, whatever our PMOS transistor is there, that will be in the on state. That means due to the presence of this inverter. Okay. So this bubble. Okay. So this is not. Okay. Right. So this will be in the on state. And the same zero value, that is logic zero, it is passing through this NMOS transistor, but it will be in the off state. Now we will be representing with the equivalent diagram. Okay. So let us consider this is the PMOS transistor, and you know that this is in the on state, right? So we can represent it by a short circuit. And then the NMOS transistor, the same zero it is going here. That means the NMOS transistor will be open circuited like this. Okay. So this is our equivalent circuit. That means there is no connection here from this NMOS transistor to the gate, sorry, ground terminal. That means here there is no connection, and here the PMOS transistor is on, that is short circuited, and there is a connection to this VDD. Always the VDD will be of high value, either you can take it as 5 volts or 1 volt. Okay. So whatever this VDD value is there, power supply value, that will be passing like this, and here we are having the output, right? So we will be getting the input, the output as a logic 1. Okay, so this is how we are going to explain. That means in the region 1, the operation will be like this. Okay, and then coming to this region 2. Here, what we are going to do means in this region 2, first I have applied the input as logic 0. Now, coming to this region 2, I am just increasing our logic 0 value. That means let us consider 0.2. Okay, so let us consider this is the threshold voltage of this particular NMOS transistor. I am just applying the more value greater than this threshold voltage of this particular NMOS transistor. So by applying like this, what is going to happen? So this NMOS transistor will be also in the on state. That means here, what is going to happen means NMOS transistor will be in the on state, and we will be telling it as it will be in the saturation region. Okay, and same 0.2 value I am applying to the PMOS. For the PMOS, only if you are applying the value 0 means it will be inverted. So here the NMOS transistor, the PMOS transistor will also be, it will be on the on state. But here whatever this potential difference is there, for this NMOS transistor it will be having more, because we are applying the voltage which is the more than this threshold voltage of this NMOS. We are mainly concentrating on this NMOS now. So it will be having the more potential difference here, and the PMOS transistor will be having some less potential difference, and we will be telling it as it is in the non-saturated region. Okay, so this is for the coming to this second region. And now for the third region, what is going to happen means both these NMOS and the PMOS transistors will be in the saturation region. In this region only the CMOS transistor will be having the high gain in the region 3. Okay, and then coming to this fourth region, it will be reverse of this particular second region, right? So here the PMOS transistor will be in the saturation and the NMOS transistor will be in the non-saturation region. Okay, so that means what? Here we will be applying the voltage that is greater than this threshold voltage of this PMOS, and as you know that there will be a large voltage difference, that is the potential difference between the source and drain terminals. Okay, so this will be also in the on state, but here the potential difference will be somewhat less when we compare with this PMOS transistor, right? So that is the reason we will be telling it as the non-saturation region, that is the NMOS transistor will be in the non-saturated region. And next, coming to this region 5, here now we will be applying the value as 1. That means what? Here first, for the first condition I am applying 0. Next I am applying 0.2. Let us consider here we are applying 0.4. Here I am applying a lot, about 0.8. Then we will be increasing the value to the highest value, that is the logic 1 I am going to apply. Okay, so now I am applying the input as logic 1. Okay, right. So now I am giving, that means the input 1, the logic 1 will be passing to this PMOS transistor and the NMOS transistor also. Okay, so here as applying this, by applying this input as a logic 1, our PMOS transistor, what it is main operation, it will be inverting, right? So that 1, it will be inverted here. That means we will be telling that the pull up transistor, that is the PMOS transistor, will be in the off state and the NMOS transistor will be in the on state. That means the same value we will be getting. Again we have to tell with the help of the equivalent circuit, right? Excuse me, yeah. I am applying the input as logic 1. Now, our PMOS transistor will be off. That means what we are going to represent in the equivalent circuit as the open circuited, right? And now then we will be giving the same well. That means NMOS transistor will be short circuited. This is our VDD and this is our VSS. Okay, so there is no connection here. Okay, there is no connection. So we are not going to get here, and directly from this ground, that is ground means zero only, right? So from here we will be getting the value as logic 1. Okay, so in this way we will be explaining with the help of the, if we are placing a capacitor here, we can tell charging, 0 means charging and 1 means discharging, like this. Okay, so this is how the CMOS inverter operation will be explained in the